Greetings, my fellow apocalypse survivors, Rhadamant here. Thank you for tuning in to Project Zomboid Arctic, episode 26, Crop Tender. All right, Frosty, here we go. Where are you guys going? No, she has some sort of bladed spear in her. Unlike last time, I think I am going to make the change to machete before I become tired, so it's more effective. A lot of zombies here. You also drive with an open window at negative 41. That's good to know. I'd close my window if I had one. I kind of don't. I really want one though. That would be a goal to propose, to find a car window for my van. No, don't grab me. Bad zombies. I am your guest of honor. And there goes my comrades. Ooh, you have a crowbar. I am the main dish. I know. I don't like it. Really? Is my bid blockers already worn off? Fine, I'll take more. It is really hard to fight in this cold and encumbrance, because I don't get to swing a lot. But they're whittling down. My exertion hasn't climbed to high yet, which is good. Oh, there goes the sun. You know, at noon. Oh, it's a fresh crowbar, too. Don't see a lot of those. I feel like the wind sounds very zombie to me. We'll give this lady's stick and a screwdriver a go. See if it's any good. It won't be. Watch for one at the window. Copy that. This seems like a good place to sit and have myself a nice read, right? Nice, toasty, lovely environment. Negative 60 Celsius with the wind chill calculated in. Making snow angels. It looks like I made like 30 snow angels. I got real good at that. Or snow demons. They were like demons. Knock, knock. Carrots. Well, you know how I was looking for the farming magazine. Lo and behold, I could also take the rain barrels. That way I can set up plumbing back home without having the adequate carpentry skill. It's not an entirely bad idea. I am really curious about what the game says about the weather. What is it, 92.8? So let me add another preset. I think their stockroom boy is trying to eat me. Sounds entirely unfriendly. No, it's the one at the window. Never mind. Come on. Oh, alright. Thought it was gonna be worse than that. Why, hello there! Well, this borrowed weapon's a little underwhelming, but got the job done. Propane tank. Okay. Don't mind. Don't mind at all. So I believe, other than anything that would be harvestable in the fields here, which looks to be none, everything left is just the rain barrel. So I got like one bag of fertilizer, which is fine. Do I have enough saws? Yeah, once you have one saw, you have enough saws. Because saws don't ever break. They're not a tool that has a durability, so good on that. Oh, these are okay. Interesting. These rain barrels somehow have water in them. I can pour it out on the ground, pick them up. But I do think it would be a good idea, and a very lazy, easy idea, just to grab the rain barrels and hook up plumbing at home with them. Oh, shoot, shoot, shoot. No, wait, no, that's fine. I misread the transfer. Well, let's get some more. You're reasonably certain snow can't fill rain barrels? While yes, my mods allow it. So I'm reasonably certain it doesn't matter. That one's broken. The time it would take me to back up the van is greater than the time it would take me just to walk the extra 20 feet. And firing up the van makes noise. Oh, got both. Nice. There's a proof that it fills up itself. Rain barrel pour on ground. Try to pick it up. Oh, didn't fill up fast enough. But yeah, I have a mod that snow is water.
let's grab these shelves then. Why were you scared? You heard them pounding the whole time. You know what? I am going to get the last shelf too. Yeah, whoever gave all these zombies little creepy violins has a sick sense of humor. I am large metal shelf man. My arms are metal shelves. Ooh, started first try. I was not expecting that. Well, that was not too bad. I didn't have to kill too many upon arrival. You guys submitted a whole lot of ideas, so while I am driving back, we can pull on that. What to do for tomorrow. We have got stairs to the roof. That'd be a heck of a staircase, stairwell to heaven. But alright, get better weapons. So like hardware store or something. I'm not really sure where I like pawn store maybe. Repair the van. Level mechanics. Find a scarf. And yeah, the others are kind of duplicates or iterations of those goals. Oh god, oh god, oh god, oh god. Ugh. Aren't y'all chilly? It's a little nippy out of here and I don't see a lot of winter coats. Is that just a backpack? Yeah. That's like a backpack that it took off a zombie and didn't bother grabbing. But these last two shelves, I probably have a just amp. I mean, I wanted dressers and bureaus, but I think I'm just going to settle for shelves because they don't break. And that will allow me to have clothing, finally. So I don't have to store it on the floor. Let's go get those rain barrels. Before I do that, it might be wise to try to figure out where I want the source of water. So I'll do the farming stuff next. Don't worry about my little propane collection. It's totally normal. Red skeleton? Yeah, every now and then they get picked over a little bit. Apparently the dead bodies are tasty to zombies. Just zombie things. I'll just keep using the spear with the screwdriver. It's actually held up pretty good, which I'm surprised by. Why am I encumbered? Probably because I run around with like a sledgehammer in my backpack. That can't be too lightweight. Oh, the spare crowbar. I think I'm going to move weapons all the way down. Out from where they currently are here. Cheers. And that way, as I add more weapons to the base, I can just add more shelves to accommodate the weapons, so it's like an ever-growing shelf of weapons. If we want to go down that route of collecting weapons. Not a terrible idea, given the difficulty and the scarcity of loot. That's why I've been grabbing every possible crowbar that I find. Just so that I'm never down on my hands. And then this is metalwork, so I'm going to move the electrical next to the metalwork. And then I have two full shelves solely for clothing. Slightly better organization than I had, I think. There is some miscellaneous that I have on me, and I'll put that, I don't know, somewhere else. For now, they're going on the clothing shelf. So there's like radio, knife. The knife can go into the kitchen, as can the bourbon. I'll grab that now. And maybe the mop too, and the cigarettes. Oh yeah, there's a lot of miscellaneous here. Finally getting a little organization. Looks like you guys want me to try to find a scarf, so I'm gonna go clothing shopping tomorrow. Probably the best place for a sink would be right here, if I could try to figure out what is directly above so I can plumb it proper. We'll see. Is this radio? Yeah, I don't really know what's going on with that radio. Like, refuses to be right-clickable. This one, too. Whatever. I don't really care. So I'll keep my spare cigarettes and spare lighters under the sink. You know, where, like, accidental water leak would take it out completely. And I'm sure having a katana point out from the edge of the table, that's totally, totally not going to backfire on me, right? Oh, man. It's one of the things that I've learned recently with, you know, having a kid that tries to grab everything, is you have to be really careful where you place things, because if it's like below my waist on a shelf or something, It's getting yoinked to the ground. Food, utensils, doesn't matter what it is, it's getting yoinked. Alright, so we have now got pretty much everything put away except for the like wood planks, which I wasn't planning on putting away anyway. I think what I'm going to do is to hook up plumbing right now. Because we have the rain barrels, and I might as well just start having them passively collect water from the roof, or from the deck, or patio, whatever is above me. Where the heck did I put... Probably in here. Pipe wrench. There it is. Okay. Let's go get a sink from the apartments. Do brokatanas have any use? No, they don't. Purely, entirely cosmetic. Did I break it? Yeah, I broke it. Yeah, katanas can't be fixed, whereas machetes can. I am only keeping it just because it's a katana. Might as well have it, right? But they don't have any use, unfortunately. A trophy. Exactly. Just a trophy. And I can track roughly how many kills I have. I have 127 kills with long blade. Probably most of those are with the katana. Okay. How to figure out how to figure out what is directly above that sink is going to be a little tricky. But I'll try. I think the storm is passing at least. Yeah, the skylight is the farm's width, so it is 1, 2, 3, 4 cells northwest of the skylight, and then it's just trying to figure out how far it is from the, from the southwest edge. Has the electricity expired? Yeah, it actually started expired. So I can kind of see. So I think it's... Maybe I'll just plop a bunch of rain barrels down. Somewhere around here. One of these rain barrels will probably be able to plumb to it. And it's already building up water. There's already like 2 units of water in there. Just making sure that my only one generator was on, and it was. Are naginatas and glaives a thing I can assemble? Sort of, yeah. You can stick a machete or a machete at the end of a spear. And that's pretty close to a naginata, I guess. My spear skill sucks, though, which is why you don't see me doing that. Because it would just be pretty much a waste of a really good weapon. I did it last stream, and oh yeah, it's plumbing. Done. So now we have fresh water from the roof that doesn't need boiling. That's really good. I went for fertilizer and ended up with plumbing. Nice. Well, it's getting already pretty late. Let me... As much as I like this little spear with the screwdriver, I think I'm going to put it away. It's not going to be my main weapon here. Plop that down. And you guys wanted me a clothing store shop? I think I have an idea of where I want to go for that. So I'll mark that on my map in the morning when I wake up. Ooh, I have some cabbages ripe to harvest. Isn't that infinite because of the snow outside? Well, it requires snow to accumulate into the barrels, so it's finite because the barrels have a finite amount of water in them, and then it takes a while for it to fill up. But it's renewable. With that said, the pool here is infinite. There's an infinite amount of water in this pool. So I'm never, ever, ever going to need water, in other words. The pool water is tainted. It does need to get boiled, which is why I set up the plumbing. So I wouldn't have to jump through the hoops of boiling water every time I wanted water, because that does get eventually annoying. So right now, there is 89 units of water in the barrel, and there's actually only one barrel connected to it. I don't know which one it is. At some point, I can try to... I'll go up there, and it's going to be whatever barrel is least full, because I've been drawing water from it. In fact, I could go up there now before I go for my shopping run to figure out what barrel's actually plumbed to it. Because once I figure that out, I can move the other barrels into position so it can also feed the same sink. You can have, I think, up to 8 barrels feed one device or one plumbing thing. Which is a lot of water. That's like a you will want not for water. So what barrel? 70 units, 92, 100, and 98. So I think it's the first one closest to the generator is the one that is actually plumbed. Do cabbages give seeds? They do, if you wait for them to... Oh, you know what I just realized? I don't want to move these yet, because, I'm probably just going to break them, given my carpentry skill. I'm going to wait until I can actually make my own rain barrels, because otherwise I'm just, like, breaking things that I can't necessarily replace. So, it's best not to fiddle with that. Alright, so here's what I wanted to go for the clothing store, which is not actually technically a clothing store, but it has a lot of good clothing, which would be this building. It's a giant warehouse full of a huge eclectic amount of stuff, and I am going to leave the gas can... Well, no, I'll bring the gas can with me just in case of emergency. Take the trailer. Ooh, that is very... tempting. I think I will. Normally I would avoid taking the trailer just because trailers could be really, really, really annoying to drive with. But it's a pretty straight shot over there, and I am going to want carry weight likely if this is to be a successful... Where did the gas can go? Did I just dump it onto the ground? Oh no, it's in the trunk. I was going to put it in the glove box to free up more space. The trailer is what, southwest of me on an SUV or something like that? Where was the trailer? I'll look for it for a second. Get this thing started. Yeah, it's right there. Easy. All these zombies are in like summer wear. I think this SUV is so destroyed. No, it has a window that... Oh, no, it's not letting me uninstall it. Yeah, it's beyond totaled. It's a car wreck. Okay, that's fine. I was hoping to get a window off of it, but it's too far gone. So it's a 80 kilo trailer. Not bad. Wonder if I'm close enough to attach. Nope, no, that was to bull driver. Attach, bull driver. Oh, you know, maybe I can drag the bull driver away, allowing me to take the trailer a bit more easily. I hope the game doesn't fling me. Every now and then when you attach at weird angles like this, the game will just like yeet you into next week. But it had some mercy on me. Didn't send me flying. I think they've solved most of those problems, though. Most of those bugs of being flung as a result of attachment errors. But it happens more on multiplayer, I think, than single player. But it's very funny when it happens. I'm not going to worry about food, because I'm probably going to find some food while I'm at the warehouse, as it is got a lot of it. So I've got about 180 kilos worth of carry space. And if you see heavy-duty vehicles that aren't completely totaled. Oh, shoot. I will happily take the windshields and windows. The pieces of this van that are the most likely to be destroyed. Let's go ahead and I'll do another suggest goals. Why not? You guys are coming up with awesome stuff. So, right turn on next intersection. I'm glad I have my little map quest in TomTom that I know predates 93. Well, maybe not map. When did map quest come out? Something like this. Ooh. Yep. Pit stop. I see a window. That van actually looks like it's in pretty decent shape, too. Which can be very useful when you're trying to repair a vehicle, because you can just take the best pieces of two vehicles and combine them into one. Which I intend to do. Just curious if any of these guys have keys or anything like that. I think there's a few more zombies in the area. Have I visited the baseball? Nope. I've not gone to the baseball factory. All right, we've got, whoa. All right, so it's a 99 condition engine. This van is maybe even in better condition than my own. It has a standard gas tank, so my gas tank's a little bit larger than its. Its trunk is larger. Yeah, this is just straight up better condition than mine. I think I'm going to have to smash a window to get inside, though. Which was the problem of the first van. I could try to forge for keys. I'll try that in a sec. So if you... I need to take off my balaclava. Because it hurts my forge. And then if you aim, like a nimble walk, it increases your... search radius, aiming bonus 33%. It doesn't quite offset the whole, it's a freaking storm out here. But no, I don't think I'm going to find any keys. Not unless they're on this zombie. Nope. All right. Let's smash the... Oh, hi there. Let's smash you. I don't have any particular loyalty to the car that I'm driving, so I might switch if this one ends up better. I'm gonna smash the front right, even though the front left is in lower condition. Question for you all. What van should I keep? I'll get this one hotwired. What should be the primary van? I guess I could keep both if I tow one back and then come back for the trailer. Now, the biggest thing would be the engine quality. And this engine's quality is really low. Loudness 58, quality is 21. So I'll do a quick side-by-side. Because those numbers can't be changed, right? They're built baked in. So the white van's engine is higher quality, but still not great. It's like 37 versus 21. So both engines are bad. The blue engine is slightly worse. And then the, but it has better pieces on it. So I'm going to re-pull here, I know, because I hadn't read those numbers. And then there's also the muffler, although mufflers can be swapped, so... The engine on the white van is better. The muffler here is average engine loudness multiplier 1.18. And this sort of determines how stealthy you can drive around. Engine quality governs stallouts and stuff like that. I always mix it up for the condition versus engine quality. But I think it's like how quick it is to start. The white van is a 370 horsepower. Maybe this is more horses. We'll see. Nope, they're the same horses. Yep. And they're roughly the same loudness, too. Well, if I needed a welder's mask, this dude just waltzed in with one. That would have been really convenient a little while ago. Engine quality is the ability to start. Okay, thanks. I always forget which is which. Condition is stalling while driving. A cargo space in the blue is a little better, but the cargo space in the white can be repaired. Because cargo space is just like trunk quality. And now I'm gonna absolutely botch the window. So it looks like it's a tie. And I am gonna stick with white for now, but I can always switch to the blue. I can make a note to myself to, tow the blue bag once I don't have a trailer attached. Oh, is this the... No, this isn't the building. So let's mark this down. It's a working van. Dude, can dumpsters collect water? Nope. Buckets, paint buckets, any, like, liquid containers can collect water. Rain barrels. But things that can have items in them... things that can have liquids in them can collect water. Things that can't have liquid in them can't collect water. So, like, you can collect water in, like, mugs and cups and bowls. Because they contain liquids, not solids. If that helps you think about it that way. It's not exactly true, because of course you can make salads. But it's not like you can put paper clips into a bowl. It's not a container like that. Duffel bags were empty. Military boots, high-vis vest. It used to be that, like, things like gasoline could only be put into gas cans. But then the game got updated and expanded upon its, like, liquid containers. So you can put, like, you know, kind of any liquids in a liquid container, any solids in a solid container. It's a little bit more nuanced than that, but that would be the TLDR. Yeah, once upon a time, if you didn't have one of those red gas cans, you couldn't, like, you needed one to fuel up a vehicle. There was no alternative, which was a little rough if you got unlucky and you just couldn't find a gas can. That happened to me. But now it's like, oh, you know, I'll just get a coffee mug and fill it up with gasoline. Of course, it's extraordinarily inefficient, but it would work. Guess who can't drive with the trailer? Is that a beanie? Yeah, I don't need beanies. That's not a bad parking job considering the warehouse is right here. Trailers do roughly mimic real life, yeah. It's going to be easier to go through this than the Louisville series, because you can see the insanely rare loot modifiers affecting this place. Can you stop running for me? There's so many empty shelves. But I have some hope that I'll find some scarves, so we'll see. Hey, Azure Storm, thank you for the resub. Keep on keeping on. What's going on with Twitch today with a resub notices doubling up? You're not the first one that I've seen that happen to. Just Twitch being weird. Oh, speaking of empty gas cans, there's one. Oh, and another. Hang on. Wow. I'm gonna have to do a gas run soon. Annotated map. Crazy guy rip. Crazy gun guy's house. So we have a prepper house. That looks to be in hell. Let me mark that down on my own map. So that's here-ish? I gotta check the annotated one again. So it is a green backwards L, and it is second from the top, just right of the tri-block area. So that is right here. Had a note. Prepper house. Cool. I don't know what that marking is. I'm going to get rid of it. Oh, right. I remember. Do we need more shelves? Probably not. But I could always grab some. If I haven't filled up my inventory full of stuff that I want to keep. I think I'm gonna grab the metal sheet too. It's good for car repair. Thank you for tuning in to Project Zomboid Arctic, which originally streamed live on Twitch May 4th. If you have any feedback or questions for me, let me know in the comments below. If you'd like to catch a live stream of mine, Rhadamant.com has my stream schedule and countdown timers to upcoming streams. If you'd like to join my gaming community, Rhadamant.com also has a link to Discord, as does the description of this video. Thank you so very much for watching, and a special thank you to my Patreon patrons, Twitch subscribers, and viewers like you that support the channel and made it all the way to the credits. Thank you so very much. I hope to catch you next episode or an upcoming stream. Farewell, my fellow zombie slayers.